blessed to be here again, that we are to remain witnesses of Christ and Christ in our lives, that we draw others to the kingdom of God. We thank God for Jesus. That was an awesome prayer. Awesome prayer. Awesome, awesome prayer. Yeah, thank God. Praise the Lord. It is the 11 o'clock hour, so we're going to move forward and go right into service. Is there anyone still lingering outside? Anyone still lingering? Can you open the doors, please, and see if there's anyone still lingering? We want to make sure we get everyone involved in prayer. Praise the Lord. Thank God, thank God. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Praise God. Good morning to you all. Good morning. Now, just in case, so you won't be confused, that wasn't the prayer to open service. No, that was a prayer in obedience to our pastor. Amen. So, some I hear it already. Some saying, "Well, that's enough. That's a good one." No, the Bible say, "Pray always, and faint not." So we gonna pray again, amen, and again until the glory come down. Praise the Lord. Amen. Come on, let's rise to our feet. Thank God. Thank you, Jesus. We're missing a few today that are normally here. We're going to pray for them as well. Praise the Lord. Glory to God. If you're able to stand, we're going to ask that you please stand. Minister Dee Dee, making sure pastor okay. Amen. Thank God for Minister Dee Dee. And with bowed heads. Our Father and our God. God, we love you. We can't say it enough, Lord. We love you. For you loved us first. You led the way. You showed us how to love. In the midst of us being unloving, you loved us first. Therefore, Lord, love entered in and allowed us to love you in return. We thank you for being the example, Lord. We thank you for, in the midst of our sins, you didn't toss us aside. You welcomed us in and you provided a way of escape, Lord. Father, we thank you today for you died on the cross. You shed your precious blood that we today can stand and say we are the righteousness of God in Christ Jesus. God, if it had not been for you, that would not be possible today. So today, while I have breath in my body, we say thank you, Lord. We say thank you, Lord. Thank you for dying on the cross for us, Lord. Thank you for shedding your blood, Lord. Thank you for being the first to love us, Lord. That when we didn't love ourselves, when we didn't understand what it was, you said, we love you and you welcomed us then. You touched us. You provided us with your spirit of peace, with the spirit and the blood covering our lives. You provided us a way of escape, Lord. We thank you, Jesus. Thank you for your blessings, Lord. Thank you for your worship, Lord. Thank you for leading us and guiding us into the path of righteousness. For your name's sake, and yea, though I walk through the valley filled with the shadows of death, I shall fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod, your staff, it comforts me, Lord. We thank you, Jesus, for the providing of all things, for we are the spiritual relevance in the earth today. God, we thank you for power from on high, for there's no spirit that can overtake us, Lord. We are the righteousness of God in Christ Jesus. We thank you today, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you for those who are yet on the way, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you for the sick and shut in, Lord, that your healing virtue may go forth. Cause them to do as Lazarus did, Lord. Rise up from the bed. Rise up from the death. Come forth, you said. Live and prosper in the name of Jesus. We thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you for your many, many blessings, Lord. Thank you for your manservant today. Thank you for the choir who will sing your praises. And God, thank you for our assistant pastor who will stand in the gap today, who will bring forth the word of God. We ask that you empower her, Lord. Cause all things to flow through her as you see will. Cause the gifts of the Holy Ghost to work and manifest, Lord. Let deliverance flow in the earth today, Lord. We thank you today. Bless our families. Father, rekindle and unite the marriages. We thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Bring us all into subjection, Lord, into the obedience of the word of God. God, we thank you today, Lord, for you're yet on the throne and we can come to you and partake in your blessings. We thank you for it, God, for your hand are upon us and our eyes are upon you. And in the name of Jesus Christ, we thank you and all that believe said, amen. Come on, give my hand of praise. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. Grab your Bibles if you will. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Amen. Would you turn with me to Matthew chapter 5? Matthew chapter 5. That'll be our opening verse for our opening scripture for today. Thank you, Lord. Matthew 5. And we're going to start right at verse 1. Some of you refer to these as the Beatitudes. But today they are a reminder of the blessings that Christ has already prepared for you. Amen. That's chapter 5 of Matthew, starting at verse 1. If you have it, say amen. Amen. And it reads, and seeing the multitudes, he went up into a mountain. And when he was set, his disciples came unto him, and he opened his mouth and taught them, saying, blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are they that mourn, for they shall be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they shall inherit the earth. Blessed are they which do hunger and thirst after righteousness, for they shall be filled. Blessed are the merciful, for they shall obtain mercy. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they shall see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they shall be called the children of God. Blessed are they which are persecuted for righteousness' sake, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are ye, which men shall revile you and persecute you, and shall say all manner of evil against you falsely, for my sake. Rejoice and be exceedingly glad, for great is your reward in heaven. For so persecuted they the prophets which were before you. And we're going to stop right there. Amen. That is an encouraging word for you today from your own God in heaven. No matter what you're going through, God said, blessed be you. Bless means the favor of God is upon you. Even when men speak bad of you, say thank God. For you know, according to his word, he said it real clear here. He said, rejoice, that means be glad, and be exceedingly glad, for great is your reward in heaven. So he has not forsaken you. He will remember you all the way through. Amen. Praise God. Come on, give him a hand of praise. Hallelujah. Thank God for Jesus. You may be seated at this time. And before the choir comes, are there any first-time visitors among us? Any first-time visitors, would you please stand? Amen. No first-time visitors today. Praise God. Well, let's give yourselves a hand of praise. Amen. Wow, only one. Do you know that when you come here from week to week, that means the devil's been defeated? Remember, the Bible says in Peter that he came to kill, to steal, and to destroy. He wants to take you out. So if you are making it here from week to week, you have defeated him. You are still standing. And the Bible says to those who are joined to the living, there is hope. You are still standing. Now, once again, give yourself a hand of praise. Amen. Amen. And here they are, praise of deliverance.
Praise God. How many of you know that Jesus is the Lion of Judah?
Amen.
And we're going to praise him for who he is today. You're the Lion of Judah.
Lion of Judah.
You are my Lord and King.
You are my Lord and King.
You're the Lion of Judah.
Lion of Judah.
You reign over everything.
You reign over everything.
You're the Lion of Judah.
Lion of Judah.
You are the great I am.
You are the great I am.
Lion of Judah.
Lion of Judah.
You rule over all the land.
You rule over all the land.
You're holy.
Holy.
Mighty.
Mighty.
Worthy.
Worthy.
Of the glory.
Glory.
Holy.
Holy.
Mighty.
Mighty.
Worthy.
Worthy.
Of the glory. That's
glory.
Why I lift your name on high.
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 You're the Lion of Judah.
Lion of Judah.
You are my Lord and King.
You are my Lord and King.
You're the Lion of Judah.
Lion of Judah.
You reign over everything.
You reign over everything.
You're the Lion of Judah.
Lion of Judah.
You are the great I am.
You are the great I am.
Holy.
Come on, clap your hands, hallelujah. Come on, clap your hands, clap your hands, clap your hands. Come on, come on. I don't know what's going on with the key. It's going on crazy, amen, but we got to worship God anyways, eh? Come on. Help me lift him up. Come on, say it. Help me lift him up. Come on, say it again.
Help me lift him up. Help me lift him up.
Help me lift him up.
Help me lift him up.
Help me lift him up.
Help me lift him up.
Higher and higher.
Higher and higher.
Help me lift him up.
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 Help me lift up the name of Jesus.
We gotta lift you up anyhow, hallelujah. I said we gotta lift you up anyhow, hallelujah. Come on, get God a praise today, hallelujah. Come on, get God a praise, hallelujah. I said get God a praise, hallelujah. In spite of what goes on, we gotta lift him up anyhow, amen. Come on, turn to the neighbor, say, neighbor, help me lift him up. Turn to the other side, say, neighbor, help me lift him up. Come on, let's get God a praise. Amen. We're going to move on with the service. Come on, let's go.
Hallelujah. Help me lift him up. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Any day he lifts me up, I can lift him up from that point on. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. What a good day it is. Anytime you wake up and you didn't wake yourself up, he woke you up on this morning. Hallelujah. Let's give God some praise. Come on. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. It's time to lift him up with all that we can now financially. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. If you turn in your Bibles to Luke chapter 6, verse 38, a very familiar scripture. Hallelujah. As we welcome into our presence the angel of this house, Apostle Reginald Lawrence, Dr. Lawrence. Come on, let's give him a hand. Come on. Please stand to your feet. Stand to your feet. Hallelujah. Luke chapter 6, verse 38. Luke chapter 6, verse 38. Hallelujah. Glory to God. I love the sound of those pages when they be turning. I know those iPads are good, but I still like the sound of those pages. I'm still old school. I love it. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Luke chapter 6, verse 38. It says, give and it shall be given unto you. Good measure, pressed down and shaken together and running over, shall men give into your bosom. For with the same measure that you meet withal, it shall be measured to you again. Which not the first time, it says again. You may have your seats. Glory to God. God says, if you give, I'm going to give it back to you. I'm going to make sure. And how are you going to know that it's going to happen? He said, he's going to make sure. He says, he's going to give it back to you. He's going to send men, human beings, to give you what you're giving unto him. Hallelujah. And it's not for you. It is not for our apostle, our angel of this house. It's not for me. It's not for anyone except for our glorious Father, our Father God. Right? Amen. It says in Luke 6:38, give. So that's what we're going to do today on our envelopes. The ushers have envelopes. Those that don't have an envelope, if you would please just raise your hand and they'll be sure to, there's a hand right over here. Amen. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. We want to give unto the house because the house has needs. It has physical needs. We can pray, and we can shout, and we can dance, and we can lay hands, but if we don't pay the bills, they're going to turn the lights off. And we're not going to allow that. Amen. Praise the Lord. Make sure that you fill it out completely on the front. Put your name and your address completely. We want to be sure that at the end of the year that you get back a full accounting of all that you're giving unto this house. Amen? Amen. Because it's important. We want to make sure that every penny that comes in here, that's why Apostle insists, and that's what the law says, if you put money into a tray, it should have a name attached. It doesn't just happen. Amen. We want to make sure that everything is fully and completely accounted for. Put your name and your address, and on the right-hand side of your envelope, you're going to see some columns. Make sure you put in there tithes, which we know you're going to do, and your offerings. This is what you really want to give from your heart. Amen? And then the next column down is our beloved pastor's slot. We want to be sure we give into that one because he gives unto us in prayer. He prays for us every morning, at night, and throughout the day and throughout the week. So let's give unto him what we can give to him tangibly because love is a tangible thing. It's one thing to say you love somebody, but we want to show it. We want to be demonstrative. If I told my wife, my lovely wife sitting to my left, if I said, I love you, and I never gave her not one flower, they come in 12s when you get flowers. They come in, I got to give her 12 flowers. I gave her 3 cars on every day. Not every day, every special day. She wants something tangible. I want her to know that I love her, not just paying a bill. Not just say I love the meal. I want her to have something very tangible. So I have to give her something. We want to give unto this house. We love God. How many love God? Raise your hand. A show of hands. I'm looking around. All hands are up. That means we all love God. Let's give unto God into this house. So we want to make sure we have a building fund. That wall, everybody look to the right. You think you see a wall? It's really not there. Because the building fund has knocked that wall already down. And we've expanded all the way out to that wall that's out there. You just don't see it yet. There's a hallway going down to my office. Okay. All right, hallelujah. And we're going to pass on the way to my office. You're going to see the children's classrooms. And on the other side of that, you're going to see the cafeteria. And on this wall over here, that's going out too. On this side over here, we're going to see the playground, the basketball court. And on this, going over this way, we're going to have our senior citizens' homes. We're just going to take all, and all these houses you see now, we're going to let them stay. But that building over there, the Quality Inn or whatever it's called, that's ours. That's going to be ours. That's our headquarters. All right. Hallelujah. So at the very bottom of the envelope, to ensure that this happens, because we are men giving into God's vision, put your credit card number on there if you don't have a check. So we taking care of you. You don't even have to worry about a check. And we're going to give into a secure website. Those that are on, if you can get a vision of that right there. Yes. You will be able to give on the website. Click codii.org, and you're going to go to donations. You'll be able to give very securely right there. And at the very bottom, you put your 16-digit number, the expiration date, and then nobody's going to know this, that 3-digit code. Okay? Put that 3-digit code on the back of your card on the very front. Then sign it at the bottom so we know that it's really you that authorized us to do it. No one's looking over your shoulder, but just in case, do that. Can we do that? Praise the Lord. Amen. Ushers, please come forward. Amen. A little giving music, up tempo. Look, give. Come on, up tempo. Amen. You're in the hands of the usher. I know everybody want to give again now, right? Okay. Thank you, Dr. Howard. I'm telling you. Hallelujah. And we are blessed to have him in this house. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Let us pray. Our Father and our God, Lord, we thank you for another day of life, health, and strength, and the opportunity to give into your kingdom, to advance it, Lord. We thank you, Father, for those that gave and those that had a mind to give, but yet did not have the means. We thank you, Lord, and we ask that you increase it 100-fold in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. Amen, and thank God. Come on, let's give everyone that gave a hand of praise. Come on, let's give God a praise. And you're now in the hand of the Praise of Deliverance Choir.
Amen. Everybody stand. Everybody stand. We're getting ready for the word. Amen. Yeah. Oh, that didn't sound like you guys are ready. I said, we're getting ready for the word.
Amen.
Yeah. Everyone, turn to your neighbor. Say, neighbor, are you ready for the word? Let's prepare our hearts, amen, and our minds for the first lady of this house is bringing the word on today, amen. Come on, say this with me. The Lord is here. Lord is here. He has established his name, and he shall reign forevermore. Say, the Lord is here.
The Lord is here.
The Lord is here.
The Lord is
he has established
here.
His name.
He has established his name.
And he shall reign forevermore.
And he shall reign forever.
Lift your hand. Lord is here this morning.
The Lord is here.
He has established his name.
He has established his name.
And he shall reign forevermore.
And he shall reign forever.
The Lord is here. Lord, we worship
him.
The Lord is here right now.
The Lord is here.
He has established his name.
He has established his name.
And he shall reign forevermore.
And he shall reign.
Come on, sing it higher.
The
Lord is here.
Lord is here.
Lord is here right now.
Lord is
he has established
here.
His name.
He has established his name.
And he shall reign forevermore.
And he shall reign forever.
The Lord is here.
The Lord is here.
Come on, lift your hands and say,
the Lord is
he has established
here.
His name.
He has established.
He shall reign forevermore.
And he shall reign forever.
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 And he shall reign forever. Come on, somebody worship him. Establish his name. Hallelujah.
He has established his name.
He shall reign forevermore. He has established his name.
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 He shall reign forevermore. Come on. Somebody bless the Lord, hallelujah. Oh, we worship you. We give you all the praise, hallelujah. Oh, that's why we lift our hands this morning. They shall reign forevermore.
And it
shall reign.
And it shall reign forever.
And it shall reign.
And it shall reign forever.
And it shall reign forever.
And it shall reign forever.
It shall reign.
And it shall reign forever.
And it shall reign forever.
Hallelujah.
And it shall reign forever.
And it shall reign forever.
And it shall reign forever.
And it shall reign
Lift your hands all over the house and bless them this morning. Come on, lift your hands and bless them this morning. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Lift your hands in worship for your God. And thank God that the presence of our God is here. Thank you, Lord, for your abiding presence. Thank you for every day you took us through this week. And we bless you in advance for things that you're going to take us through in the coming week. Lord, this is the day that the Lord has made. And we shall rejoice. We shall be glad in it. For the Lord is on our side. Let all the people say, if it had not been for the Lord who was on my side, when my enemies rose up against me and the waters were over my head, if it had not been for the Lord, they would have swallowed me up. Oh, but blessed be the name of the Lord. He has not given my soul to mine enemies. Somebody say, my soul has escaped like a bird from the snare. Tell your neighbor the snare, it's broken. And I've got a reason to praise him. Shout hallelujah. The Lord is here. Hallelujah. And he's on my side. Hey.
Come on, the Lord is here. The Lord is here.
Woo.
God is here
right
now. The Lord is here. The Lord
is here.
He shall reign forevermore. I said, the Lord is here.
The Lord is here.
The Lord is here.
Come on, lift your hand before the Lord.
The Lord is here.
He
shall reign forevermore. And he shall reign.
Worship the Lord.
And he shall reign.
And he shall reign forever.
And he shall reign forever.
And he
shall
reign forever.
He shall reign forevermore.
And he shall reign.
He shall reign.
He shall reign forever.
And he shall reign. He
shall reign. He shall reign forever.
And he shall reign forever.
And he shall reign.
Shall reign forever.
And he shall reign forever.
He shall
your hands together. Give God a hand of praise. Yee! My. He shall reign forever. My Lord, we thank you. We look forward to the millennial reign of Christ. We are so grateful, Lord, that we have a hope that it shall be greater. Somebody say the latter shall be greater than the former, for the Lord shall reign. Hallelujah. 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 Yee! My. Yee! Good God from on high. We are the people of the Most High God. Amen. Take your seats just for a moment. We are the people of the Most High God, and we are always to give an example. We are witnesses, the Bible said, for a dying world, that they may through us see our good works and glorify our God which is in heaven. Everything that we're doing is being watched over, not just by God, but by the angels of God, but even more by the people of the world who don't know God and don't know the way. And they're being led off by the beggarly elements of this society. And so we must be upright before the Lord. We must be integral before the Lord. We must be, especially in this generation, a people of morals. Because we're living in a society that has lost its morals. And they're saying now, anything goes. But tell your neighbor, the devil is a liar. It's God's way or no way. Hallelujah. We must show that we are the redeemed of the Lord. And the redeemed of the Lord must say so. Your life must speak the character of God. If you are in the name of the Lord, then you are also in his conduct, character, authority, and his purpose. For the Greek word name is onoma. Can you say onoma? And that's exactly what it means: conduct, character, authority, and purpose. It's not enough just to say it. You've got to live it. Amen. Anybody can talk, but who God calls, he qualifies. And the Bible said, be not just hearers of the word, but be also doers of the word. And God called us to excellence. We are to be perfect, the Bible says in Matthew 5:48, even as our Father in heaven is perfect. Now, there is no perfection in the flesh, but we are to be spiritually before the Lord perfected. Our old life has been gone. We are passed from death to life, and now we are alive in Christ for this time forth and forevermore. And we are to show that maybe we don't look so great to some folk on the outside, but tell your neighbor, this is an inside job. For man looketh upon the outer parts, but God, he looketh upon the heart. And we are a people who God has called to be right at heart. The Bible says in Matthew 5:8 that none but the pure at heart shall see God. If we're going to receive the visitation of the Lord, we got to make sure that our heart's right. And I'm so glad, amen, that for every parent who is living upright in front of their children, we can know that there will come an example. And I'm so grateful, amen, to stand here before you. We're about to begin the sacrament of the Last Supper. It is the first Sunday of June, and on every first Sunday, we celebrate the sacrament, one of the most favorite sacraments of the church, is to commemorate the death, burial, and resurrection of Jesus Christ in the sacrament of the Last Supper. And so herein, before we do that, I want to just share something with you. The Bible said, give honor where honor is due. Amen? And so I want to commend a couple of people. Is Samuel Green anywhere in the house? Where are you? Will you stand up? Will you stand up? Amen. This certificate is a certificate of achievement. It's an academic achievement award presented to Samuel Green at Sutherland Elementary, 2013-2014. Samuel had showed himself exemplary in conduct and in academic excellence. And we are honored, amen, to say that he is a member of Church of Deliverance International, has been here all of his life. And we are absolutely grateful to know that his parents, who we know, would you stand up, Sister Green and Elder Green, Sister Sheila Green and Elder Green, we want to give them a hand of praise because they have led their children in a way that is circumspect before the Lord to show an example. Not only am I going to commend them, but I'm going to also share with you that I got a report card here. And this is the report card for Solomon. Samuel, the word E here, it says stands for excellence. And all I see on this report card is E's. I got one S. An S stands for satisfactory. That's in visual and performing arts. Amen. And that means he's doing all right there. But in everything else, he's doing excellent. And that's a great report for any parent to see, to know that their children are not cutting up at school. Amen. But they are setting an example of how they've been raised at home. They are mannerable, they're respectful, and they're showing themselves with promise for the future. That's a reason for every parent to be hopeful, to know that their child is on the way. Amen. That they're not going the wrong way, but they're on the way. And that they made an example or found the example of the parents to not hang around everything, the wrong things, and get themselves off track, but that they are now headed for a future of a good life. And I am so grateful. I know all of us ought to just say, thank you, Lord. Because the Bible does say to train up a child in the way that he or she should go, and when they're old, they will not depart from that. I'm so honored for that. I want to also share that there is also a commendation here for Solomon Green. Where's Solomon? Solomon's working in the back there in the sound booth. He's working in the church already. How old is Solomon? 15. And he's working in the church already. He handles the cameras in the church. So he's doing the videotaping for the website. Solomon, this says, Renaissance Student of the Semester, April 2014. Solomon is a wonderful student. He is always willing to share his knowledge and ideas with class discussions. He is a true leader. This is one of, I assume, the teachers, Mrs. Hoffmeyer from Glendora High School, recognizing a tradition of excellence. We are so grateful to know that these young men are setting the example, and I challenge every young man to step up to the plate. Amen. We must show ourselves exemplary people who are trying to accomplish in life. We're not going to have dropouts. We're going to have people who are headed for college and universities, and they're going to become successful citizens in life. They'll show mom and dad that all of the time they spent and all the money they spent was not wasted. Amen. You are an investment. Our children are an investment for our future in our family lineage. And we want to make sure that in our family there is excellence, not failures. We don't want our children to be dropouts, drug heads. We don't want them to be whoremongers. We don't want them to be liars, a thief, or jailbirds. Our children should be bringing up the rear for the next generation of professionals. Amen. We want to make sure that our children establish a career, amen, in some field, technology, doctors, lawyers, some law enforcement agents, some professional field that can be as a help to the kingdom of God. And even more, some of them might just be preachers. Amen. That's why I have to live right in front of all of them. And I am so grateful to see that all who have been in our family listening to me are coming forth. And I'm proud. Amen. I want to just commend. Would you stand, Michael? I want to commend our son, Michael, who God has been working, has brought him all along from a mighty long way. And I'm so proud. I just want to tell you, I'm encouraged. We are so proud of you. He's married. He's living in his own home. He's doing well. And I am absolutely, my wife and I, grateful for that. Amen. Bless God for you. And that's his lovely wife sitting right next to him. Amen. The Bible said if a man finds that a wife, he finds that a good thing. It's important for every young man to see the example, the picture that God wants, to know that God wants to develop family. He wants a covenant of not boyfriend and girlfriend, but husband and wife to reproduce the next generation of family. Listen, the Bible said in Malachi 2:15 that God wants godly seed. You can only get godly seed from people who are in covenant with God. And the word marriage actually means covenant of God. That means they didn't shack up, but they came before the pastor, the man of God. Not, listen to me, not the justice of the peace. Come on, because they work for the state. They don't work for God. Not the people in Las Vegas, but they came before a man who's been anointed by God. Even Jesus recognized that anybody couldn't baptize him. It had to be someone who was in covenant with God. That's why he used John the Baptist saying, this must be done by you. Amen. To fulfill all righteousness. In other words, to do it the right way. And the right way, how many know, is God's way. And God wants you to receive of the anointing, which is the affirmation of his spirit. The Bible says in Hebrews 1:14, we are sealed with the Holy Spirit of promise. And so when it is done right, God will seal it with his spirit. And when two people, man, husband, and wife, that's male and female, and I say that because the objective of marriage is to reproduce a godly seed. Hello, somebody. And it's also, he told Adam and Eve from the beginning to be fruitful and to multiply. You can multiply sin and evil, but God said he wanted to multiply his way righteousness. So he started off. Amen. And there's a law called the law of first mention. That means whatever you start off with, that's the way it's supposed to continue. It continues and continues. And so he started with a man and a woman. And he wanted that to be reproduced. He didn't start with two men, and he didn't start with two women. As a matter of fact, if you put two men on an island in 60 years, you would not have anybody else, because there would be no multiplying or reproduction. If you put two women on an island in 70 years, you would have nothing but two old folks if they made it that long. But there would be no seed reproduced. The only way that there can be reproduction is seed and womb, that's man and woman. But those can reproduce ungodly seed. So they have to get married for it to be called godly seed, because then they're in covenant with God. They're saying, God, we welcome you in this thing with us. Because shacking up is sin. The word fornication means sex outside of marriage. That's what it means. Amen. And 1 Corinthians 6:18 says, every sin that a man does is without the body, but he that commits fornication, he is sinning against his own body. And that's how diseases and sicknesses and afflictions and all those things come off, and the cutting off of the family and all kinds of different things occur, even the cutting off from God, because of this. God wants the husband and the wife to come together, not shack up, but to come before the altar and declare before the man of God, under the anointing of God and the affirmation of the Holy Ghost, that they're going to reproduce the same. The same. Man and woman. They're going to multiply godly seed, not cussing wild heathens, bad acting, drug heads, but men and women of God, that they're going to train them up in the way that they should go, God's way. And when they're old, they will not depart from that way. So in each family, maybe the past of our generations, they didn't do it right. But there's somebody who today is saying, I'm stepping up the plate to the plate, and I'm going to be the representative of our family's future. And I'm going to be the example of the future of the next generations of our family. I'm going to get this thing right. And in my line, the rest of my offspring, we're going to get it right before the Lord so we can be fruitful and multiply God's way of doing things. Let the church say amen if you agree with that. Praise the Lord. So I am absolutely grateful. Want to also add that they have a daughter, and her name is Salome Green. Where are you, Salome? Is she around? Would you stand? Let them see a young lady who carries herself, amen, with honor. And I'm so, not to say that there's many others in this church, but I just want to, since I'm commending the Green, just throw her in there too, the Green family. She's stirred up on her own. She came to us and said, Pastor, I'd like to start a praise dance team. She and Al Janae Stewart. Stand up, Al Janae. They got together and they're working to produce, amen, a dance team, a praise dance. They're going to praise dance. They're not doing the twerk or the boogaloo or none of that stuff. Nuh-uh. They're worship dancing. All right? Are you with me? Huh? And they named this team Virtuous Praise Dancers. Yeah. Proverbs 31, women of virtue. They're growing to be young ladies, but they want to show how to be graceful in dance. They're not twerking. They're not booty shaking. No, they're worshiping God and allowing their whole body and essence to be a praise before the Lord. And I am so very proud of them. Amen. Amen. I am so very proud of them. We should all be proud of them. We should all say something good about them and encourage our children to do the same. Amen? Amen. Thank God. Don't want to take any more time now that we've done that. We have a great treat now. Your first lady is going to be speaking. But before we do that, and my wife, before we do that, I want to take us to 1 Corinthians chapter number 11. We want to begin the sacrament of the Last Supper. 1 Corinthians chapter number 11. Amen. If you would all go as the deacons are bringing forth the table and the elders are taking their positions. 1 Corinthians chapter number 11. Note for your information, FYI, when the word of the Lord is being read, the people of God would stand for the reading of the word. Praise the Lord. 1 Corinthians chapter number 11. We're going to begin at verse number 23. The writer is the Apostle Paul. 1 Corinthians chapter number 11. Would you, if you're able to, if there's no physical impediment, stand just a moment for the reading of this holy writ to honor God and his word. 1 Corinthians chapter 11, verse number 23. If you're there, would you say amen? Amen. Here is the reading of the word. The writer is Paul, and he says, for I have received of the Lord that which also I delivered unto you, that the Lord Jesus, the same night in which he was betrayed, took bread. And when he had given thanks, he broke it and said, take, eat. This is my body, which is broken for you. Do this in remembrance of me. And after the same manner also, he took the cup when he had supped, saying, this cup is the New Testament in my blood. This do ye as often as you drink it in remembrance of me. Everybody say in remembrance. This is to commemorate. There's no miracle about to happen with the bread or in some places they say that the wine is being turned to the body and the blood of Christ. No, that's not happening. What this is for is to commemorate what Jesus did for us so we would know that we could not have done this for ourselves. The Bible says that in Romans 3 that all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. There's not one righteous, not one. We cannot save ourselves. Ephesians chapter 2, are you listening? Verse number 8, it says, by grace are you saved through faith. It's not of yourself, it's a gift of God, lest any man should boast. And so God has shed his blood through the body of Jesus Christ. The Bible says in Hebrews 9:22 that without the shedding of blood, there is no removal. The word says remission of sin. Blood had to be shed. And if I or you had shed our blood, we'd be dead and gone because we're in sin and it cannot be resurrected. Because Romans 6:23 says the wages or the payment for sin is death. But the gift of God, it's eternal life through Jesus Christ. And so God gave us this precious gift that God, the Bible said in John 3:16, so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son that whosoever would believe upon him would not perish but have everlasting life. And we're so grateful that Jesus, the Bible said in Isaiah 53:5-6, was wounded for our transgressions. He was bruised for our iniquities, and the chastisement of our peace was upon Jesus, and by his stripes we were healed. Amen. And so we receive this, and this sacrament is to be practiced throughout generations so we don't forget where our help come from. Let the church say amen. Now, we don't drink alcohol. The church is to never drink alcohol. Leviticus 10:9, the Bible says, do not drink wine nor strong drink, you nor your sons with you, when you go into the tabernacle, the congregation of the Lord, lest you die. It shall be a statute throughout your generations forever. And so the church is called to sobriety. That means being clear-minded and sober. Amen. And so we are not to drink alcohol. We drink wine. But in the old country, when I went to the wine presses in Jerusalem, I note that everything that came from the grape, they call wine. That which came first was called the best wine. But that wine, what we would refer to now, would actually be called grape juice. That was pure from the grape, and that's called oinos, O-I-N-O-S. Can you say oinos? So oinos means it's fresh from the grape and it's pure. That's what Jesus drank. We, the people of God, are never to drink yayin. Say yayin. Y-A-Y-I-N. That means it is now leavened and it becomes alcohol. A little leaven, the Bible said leaven's a whole lump. And so we are not to even begin this conduct because we are to be watchful. Amen. Watchful, praying. Because our adversary, the devil, is going about as a roaring lion seeking whom he might devour. To get into a family and generation. And when you drink that stuff, it's called spirits for a reason. Amen? Every liquor store calls it spirits for a reason. Because you're going to pick up spirits and they'll pass on through the lineage of your bloodline. But God wants us to be pure and holy. Let the church say amen. And so we're drinking wine or oinos, which is pure grape juice. Let the church say amen. The Lord goes on to say, for as often as you eat this bread and drink this cup, you do show the Lord's death until he comes. He says, wherefore, whosoever shall eat this bread and drink this cup of the Lord unworthily shall be guilty of the body and the blood of the Lord. But let a man examine himself. And so let him eat of that bread and drink of the cup. For he that eats and drinks unworthily, the Bible says, eats and drinks damnation to himself, not discerning the Lord's body. And the Bible says, for this cause, many are weak and sickly among you, and many sleep. Saints don't die, we sleep. Amen. So let us bow our heads in prayer as a family. And let us say, Father, your word said in 1 John 1:9, that if we confess our sins, you are faithful and just to forgive us and to cleanse us from all that is unrighteous. I confess that throughout this week, I've said things selfishly, pridefully, even profanely, that I should not have said. I've even thought things that were incorrect against others. Lord, I forgive everybody that has done something wrong to me. For our fight is not against people, but spirits that use people. And so I forgive them, Lord. And I ask for your forgiveness for my sin. And I thank you, Lord, for I believe that you are King of my life, Lord of my soul. And I renounce the devil and all of his works of evil. And I receive Christ Jesus now. Let us all say amen. We are forgiven. Forgive yourself. Now, I'm going to ask the elders to bless the bread and likewise bless around. Elder Keith Long will bless the bread and Elder Calvin Green will bless the wine.
Our Father and our God, we ask that you bless this bread in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen.
Father, we ask that you bless the wine in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior.
And I'm here to testify, God is not dead, he's still alive. The same blood that was shed way back on Calvary is the same blood that's working now for me. Oh, his blood redeems me from the stain of sin. And his blood cleanses me deep down within. So if you ask me how I made it or how I've overcome, I can tell you it's because of the blood. Yeah.
there's anyone who's not yet been served, please raise your hand. Amen. Praise the Lord. Amen. Let us now, as a family of believers, say thank you, Jesus, for your body that was broken for me. And for the blood that was shed for my sins, I thank you, Lord. That wonderful name of
Jesus.
Come on, stand on your feet, let's praise. There is power in the name of
Jesus.
There is power in the name of
Jesus.
So much power in the name of
Jesus.
Listen.
The name I know.
Listen. When I think about Jesus, what he done for me. When I think about Jesus, how he set me free, I can dance all night. Hey, yeah. Listen. I can dance all night.
All night.
All night.
All night.
I can dance. All night,
all night,
all night,
all night,
all night,
all night.
Hey, bless that wonderful name of
Jesus.
Come on, bless that wonderful name of
Jesus.
Bless that wonderful name of
Jesus. You're the name I know.
There is power in the name of
Jesus.
There is power in the name of
Jesus.
So much power in the name of
Jesus, your other name I know.
So let's praise him,
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 praise him.
Let's lift him up,
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 lift him up
a little bit higher,
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 that wonderful name of
Jesus.
Bless that wonderful name of
Jesus.
We come to bless that wonderful name of
Jesus. No other name.
I'm a soldier
in the army of the Lord.
I'm a soldier
in the army.
Got my war clothes on
in the army of the Lord.
Got my war clothes on
in the army.
I die, let me die.
In the army of the Lord.
If I die, let me die.
In the army.
For I'm a soldier.
In the army of the Lord.
I'm a soldier.
In the army.
Yeah, living and love me. Dying and save me. Buried and carried my sin far away. Thrilling and justified me. Free me forever. One day coming back a glorious name. What you know about Jesus?
He's alright.
What you know about Jesus?
He's alright.
What you know about Jesus?
He's alright.
Hey, hey.
He's my friend.
And I'm a soldier.
In the army of the Lord.
I'm a soldier.
In the army.
Oh, pray that name of
Jesus.
Pray that name of
Jesus.
Pray that name of
Jesus. No other name. Woo! I know.
Come on, let's praise him.
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 Praise, praise.
Praise, praise.
Praise,
praise.
Praise, praise.
Praise, praise.
Praise,
praise.
Praise that wonderful name of
Jesus.
Praise that wonderful name of
Jesus.
Praise that wonderful name of
Jesus.
No other name I know. No other name I know. No other name I know. Yeah. Hey. Hey. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Sheyandalabokosaya. Eyandelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelel I feel God in here. I feel the Holy Ghost. I think we stepped into something. I feel a shift in the atmosphere. The glory of the living God is in the house. Loose men. Loose men. Loose men. Loose men. In the name of Jesus. We cast the devil out. Go right now. Go right now. Shanyanda lala boko taya nada lala boko ndade. Oh. With the name of
Jesus.
With the name of
Jesus.
With the name of
Jesus. No other name I know.
With the name of
Jesus.
With that name of
Jesus,
with that name of
Jesus, no other name I know.
Hallelujah. Somebody say glory to God. Are you another Loboko Sunday? Glory to God. Kayanda the Loboko Sire. Glory. Yee. My. Touch your neighbor and say, neighbor, I think we stepped into something. I feel the anointing of God. He's in the house. Woo. My. Somebody said, my. Good God. God is good. Good. Good God. Thank you, Jesus. God said, be joyful for my spirit rest in this house. Somebody said, thank you, Lord. My. Hallelujah. Sound man. Amen. Little tap. Thank you, Jesus. We are so grateful for the presence of the Lord. Amen. Bless God. Thank you. Remain standing on your feet. Amen. It's time for a treat. So stand on your feet so you can eat your treat. Amen. Resting on your feet, would you receive Dr. Brenda Lawrence.
Praise the Lord, saints. Praise the Lord. Come on, let's praise him this morning. We give him all the praise and glory. To him. Praise your Lord. I praise you. Give him glory. Come on, just give. Come on, 1 minute. Come on. Rababa sondora le secrete. Rapahaya. Randa. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise your name, God.
Thank you.
Thank you, Jesus. Wow, God is good this morning. Amen. Have a seat. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Glory to God. Thank you. Thank you, God. Oh, release your ministering angel to fertilize the ground upon this morning. Release them, warring angels in every corner of this building. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to God. Amen, amen, amen. Praise your name, God. Well, if you're able to, please stand for the reading of the word. Go to 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, 11 through 18. Father, anoint me to preach this word. Touch the heart of your people to receive in the name of Jesus. Let their spiritual ears be able to here today in the name of Jesus. Which do you have? Amen. Thank you, Lord. 1 Thessalonians 5:11-18. If you have it, say amen. Amen. Say it again. Amen. Amen. Wherefore, comfort yourself together and edify one another, even as also ye do. And we beseech you, brethren, to know them which labor among you and are over you in the Lord, and admonish you, and to esteem them very highly in love for their work's sake, and be at peace among yourselves. Now we exhort you, brethren, warn them that are unruly, comfort the feeble-minded, support the weak, be patient toward all men. See that none render evil for evil unto any man, but ever follow that which is good, both among yourselves and to all men. Rejoice evermore. Pray without ceasing. In everything give thanks, for this is the will of God in Christ Jesus concerning you. Amen. The title of my sermon is, Let's Build One Another. Say, let's build one another. Here is my first point. Have a seat. Tell your neighbor, we need to know one another. Because when we don't know people, we often misinterpret them, and then we misjudge them. Matthew 7:1 says, judge not that you be not judged. The word know from the Greek is eido, E-I-D-O. It means to consider and to have knowledge of someone. If you haven't considered a person, if you don't have knowledge of them, then you really don't know them. From the Hebrew, the word know is yada. Say yada. Y-A-D-A-H, yada. It means to have an intercourse with. Not a sexual intercourse, but the word intercourse from the spiritual perspective deals with three things: intimacy, penetration, and a deposit. First of all, intimacy means familiarity. It means you're close and personal with a person. Secondly, penetrate means you deeply affect the senses or feeling of the person and they will listen to you. Thirdly, deposit means the person has your teaching and your spirit. Now, Webster says intercourse is an exchange of feelings or thoughts. So if none of these apply, then you really don't know the person and therefore are not qualified to speak on them. We as Christians need to be at peace among ourselves, and we do that by getting to know one another. Say one another. Know one another. Hebrews 12:14 says, follow peace with all men and holiness, without which no man shall see the Lord, looking diligently, lest any shall fall. Amen. Amos 3:3 says, can two walk together except they be agreed? God wants us to use all appropriate means to preserve peace and harmony with one another. This leads me to my second point. Tell your neighbor, we must not speak against one another. A little louder. Amen. Numbers chapter 12 records that Miriam and Aaron had spoken against Prophet Moses behind his back because he had married an Ethiopian woman. Now, God had no problem with it as long as she was a believer. But what God does have a problem with is believers gossiping and backbiting. Here was Aaron again, showing his lack of spiritual backbone, just as he did in incident of the golden calf, where he sided with wrong, where he should have stood up for the right. Amen? The Bible says in James 3 and 8 that the tongue is unruly, evil, full of deadly poison. We have to watch that tongue. Miriam sowed poison and she reaped sickness. Numbers chapter 12 shows us that God judged Miriam for her backbiting and sowing discord against Moses and his wife. Verse 10 says that sickness came upon Miriam and she became leprous, white as snow, and because she failed to control her tongue, she brought sickness upon herself. There's a lot of good people going through right now because they failed to control that tongue. We see here that Miriam's body was afflicted with leprosy, and the leprosy was affecting her soul. So God had to remove her from the congregation to give her time to repent and think about her behavior before she contaminated the whole congregation. There's an old saying that says, one rotten apple can spoil the whole barrel. Amen? So when people become spiritually corrupted, when some people become spiritually corrupted, God would move them out. Furthermore, God couldn't move the church forward until that sin was corrected. Although Miriam and Aaron were leaders in Israel, they had no right to challenge the authority of Moses. Just as God showed these two that they were not on the same level as Moses. So believers today have no right to put themselves on the same level as their leaders. Amen? Ephesians 4:27 says, neither give place to the devil, because sin opens the door for demonic attacks. There are churches that could be a lot further along today if the people knew how to love and build up one another instead of tearing each other down. We know that sin will leave you stuck in the wilderness, unable to move forward. If Miriam had any disagreement with Moses' decision, she should have first gone to God instead of speaking against him before the congregation. The Bible says in Proverbs 6:19, God hates the sowing of discord among the brethren. That's God's word. 1 Chronicles 16:22 says, touch not my anointed and do my prophets no harm. You have to keep your mouth off of the man and woman of God. God is the one to judge. God will especially judge anybody for speaking against any person who he has anointed in a position of leadership. God honors and he defends leadership, and so should we. The Bible says backbiting and sowing of discord will result in judgment. You can't get past that. There's a lot of good people who are not doing so good because they spoke against God's anointed ones. God called us to edify, to build up one another, to say that which is good and pleasing in his sight. One thing about God, he knows how to correct his own people when they're wrong. Miriam was totally out of order. What in the world made her feel that she could stand in judgment for her own brother to think evil in her heart against Moses and his wife? I began to think about that. Why? Why would she do that? Why did she do it? Did she feel intimidated? Or was it because she was a prophetess and she held a very important leadership within the community? Miriam was one of the midwives who delivered the Hebrew children and refused to obey the commandment of Pharaoh to kill all the males at birth. She was highly respected by the people for saving the lives of the Hebrew male children. Miriam also held a position in Moses' life, one of authority and leadership.
You see, when you hold a position of authority and leadership, the entry of another person may provoke jealousy, strife, and contention within you. So now, here is Miriam challenging Moses on his leadership decision. Miriam was thinking in her heart that Moses was no longer the man of God because he made a choice that she didn't like, something that she found unacceptable. Miriam got in the flesh and forgot that God had chosen and anointed Moses to be his prophet and his leader, not her. God was authority behind Moses, and only he could change the plans of Moses or correct them. We do not challenge the men and women of God with division, contention, or strife. Those are not our weapons. Prayer is our weapons. Hallelujah. Prayer is our weapon. Say, prayer is our weapon. God was letting Miriam know that she was in the way. So what he did, because she challenged Moses, the sickness came upon her. Miriam was actually judging Moses based on her own perception. Matthew 71 says, judge not that you be not judged. You see, if you make your bed hard, it's you that has to lie in it. Numbers chapter 12:11 says that Aaron had to cry out to Moses to have mercy upon them. The Bible records that Aaron had to repent for their sin. It was not until Moses forgave them, then interceded for them, and asked God to be merciful that the sickness could be removed, and the church could then move forward. But God did not remove Miriam's sickness right away. But instead, he allowed the sickness to remain 7 days. 7 days represents the number of spiritual perfection, restoration, and recovery. In other words, it remained until the effect of the punishment had been completed and Miriam's heart was changed. Miriam had fully recovered spiritually, and therefore she was restored to her place and her position. Their repentance brought mercy, and God's mercy restored her back into her present, his present, and her spiritual position. Make no mistake about it, there's a penalty for sin. Romans 6:23 says, the wages of sin is death. But 2 Peter 3:9 says that God wills that none perish, but that all come to repentance. But know this, when you repent, you are back in a covenant with God. Amen? God is merciful to anybody who will repent of their wrong. Verse 12 of the text says, know them that labor amongst you and are over you in the Lord and admonish you. This leads me to my third point. Let's help one another. Tell your neighbor, let's help one another. Let's help one another. God wants us to say that which is good and edifying. The Bible says in Proverbs 18:21 that death and life are in the power of the tongue. Ephesians 4:29 says, let no corrupt communication proceed out of your mouth, but say that which is good to the use of edifying, that is, may minister grace unto the hearers. We can build up a person with words that encourage. On the other hand, we can tear a person down and disrupt their course in life with words that discourage, talking about people, talking behind their back. Let me ask you this. What damage has your tongue caused? Think about that. What damage has your tongue caused? What good have you created with your tongue? God has called us to be fruitful and to multiply. He wants us to multiply his goodness. when God saw that Adam and Eve had opened up to evil, he moved them out of paradise. From that point on, they struggled in life to make it. Genesis 3:19 says, in thy sweat of thy face thou shalt eat bread. There are people who God can't increase nor position because they are unstable and they live in struggle and all they do is multiply evil. But God is saying to you that you will live in paradise if you multiply good. Paradise means God is supplying your needs. Hebrews 12:10 says, sow to yourself in righteousness. The Bible says that Andrew focused on sowing good seed. He sowed into the life of his brother Peter. He helped Peter. And Peter won 3,000 souls with his first sermon. And all this was added to Andrew's account because it was Andrew who helped his brother. Naomi helped Ruth. And Ruth birthed the line of Jesus. And we are his fruit. Because of Naomi's ministry to and aid in Ruth, this was added to Naomi's account before the Lord. We need to thank our pastors and other church leaders. We need to honor them. We need to aid them. Remember, what we do in their lives and ministry adds to our account before the Lord. We need to express our appreciation and sow into them. Tell them how we have been helped by their leadership and their teaching. Thank them for ministering into our lives. If you say nothing, how will they know that we appreciate them? They need our encouragement. Let them know where we stand. Their job is hard already. They don't need us to make it harder. Remember, they need and deserve your support and love. So the question is this: what words have you planted in the soul of man? What harvest will you reap? What harvest will you reap? In Exodus chapter 17:9 says that Moses told Joshua to select men to go to battle against Amalek. The Bible records in Exodus 17:11 that when Moses held up the rod in his hand, Israel prevailed against Amalek. And when he let down his hand, then Amalek prevailed. But when Moses' hands became heavy, they took a stone and put it under him to sit on. The Bible says that Aaron and Hur held up the hands of Moses until the sun went down. And because of their collective support, Joshua won the battle. When Aaron and Hur undergirded and supported Moses, and Moses interceded for Joshua, that ministry saw victory. Israel's strength and their victory lie in the continuous posture of trust, dependence, and faith in God, which was demonstrated by the uplifting of hands of Moses in intercession. When the intercession slowed, so did the flow of God's power on the behalf of his people. If we fail to call on God in daily prayer and intercession for one another, for the ministry, the flow of his grace dwindles. But when we cry out for one another, God grants us victory. Hallelujah. By helping one another, we are building one another. And we are building the ministry and the kingdom of God. The Bible says in Hebrews 4:16, let us therefore come boldly unto the throne of grace that we may obtain mercy and find grace to help in the time of need. When we do those things to help one another, we build one another. Here is my third point. Let's never give up on one another. Tell your neighbor, let's never give up on one another. Most of us know Tyler Perry. His net worth is about $400 million. But there was a time in his life when he slept in his car. I know a lot of people have slept in their car, and they're great now. You never know where God is going to take someone in life. John 1:45 recalls that Philip said to Nathanael, we have found the Messiah. And Nathanael said, can anything good come out of Nazareth, out of Linwood, out of Hawaiian Gardens, out of Compton, out of Watts? You see, it's not where you come from. It's where you're going that matters. The religious Pharisees were always condemning and looking for fault in Jesus and his disciples. But God looks past your fault to meet your needs. One thing I know for sure, we all need to be saved, we all need to be lifted up, and we all need the grace of Almighty God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Some may not yet be where you are, but don't forget where you came from. None of us were born perfect. None. Not one. The Lord didn't wait until we got it together. The truth is, without God, we can't get it together. Our righteousness is a filthy rags before the Lord. But God still loved us while we were yet in our sin and trespasses. Romans 3:23 says, we all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. Yet God looks past our faults to meet our needs. The Bible says the Lord is still sitting at the right hand of the Father, forever making intercession for us. That's all the more for us to pray for one another. That's all the more reason for us to believe in one another. Because if God be for us, then who can be against us? We are more than a conqueror with God on our side. One thing I know about God, He never gives up on us. He died for us. That's why he should never give up on one another. Matthew 26:39 records Jesus saying in a personal struggle with his own will, nevertheless, not as I will, but God will be done. They took Jesus. They beat him. They talked with him. They spit on him. They put a crown of thorns on his head. And they walked him up Golgotha Hill. And they hung him on a cross. But the Bible says he never opened his mouth. He gave it all to God and said, in thy hands I commend my spirit. They buried him. They rolled a stone over his grave. Because he never opened his mouth to say evil. God said, I will not leave my Holy One to see corruption. And on the third day, he rose from the grave. The Bible says, if you hold your peace, God will fight your battle. The next time a challenge comes your way, hold your peace and pray. God will turn it around. He will make the best of a bad situation. Say hallelujah. Praise your name, God. Hallelujah. Jesus is the answer. Jesus is the way. The next time you have that challenge, hold your peace and pray. God will turn it around. He will make the best of a bad situation. Hallelujah. Praise your name, God. I know you're a good God. You're able, God. You're Jehovah Jireh, my provider. We want to thank you, Lord, for what you get ready to do for us now in the name of Jesus. We give you glory. We give you praise, Lord. Hallelujah. You are our glory. You are the one. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah. Oh, glory to God. Hallelujah. Thank you. Thank you, Jesus. Ropa Sata. We praise your name, God. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. We praise your name, Father. Let me say this in closing, saints. 2 Peter 3:9 says, the Lord is not willing that any shall perish, but that all should come to repentance. His disciples made mistakes, but Jesus never gave up on them. He didn't discard them or throw them away. When the religious Pharisees spoke against them, he stood up for them because they were his church family. He believed in their future. He had faith in God's call upon their lives. And he laid down his life for them. John 15:13 says, greater love have no man than this, that he should lay down his life for his friend. Jesus prayed for them until his sweat was like great droplets of blood. And realized that he had to endure them. He had second thoughts, but he never gave up on them. He knew God's will for them was worth all he had to endure to keep them growing in God's vision for their lives. Yes. Jeremiah 29:11 records God saying, I know the thoughts I think towards you, thoughts of peace and not of evil, to give you an expected end. God wants to build us up. So we too should want to build one another up. Hebrews 13:17 says, obey them that have rule over you and submit yourself, for they watch for your souls, as they must give account, that they may do it with joy and not with grief, for that is unprofitable for you. Our relationship with our leaders does not mean simple face recognition. The people are to know their pastors well enough to have intimate appreciation for them and to respect them because of their values. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise your name, God. The people of the church must know their leaders as a shepherd should know his flock. So the sheep must know their shepherd. Amen. They must respect their ministers highly in love because their business is to promote the honor of Christ and the welfare of man's soul. Faithful ministers ought to be honored and highly esteemed because of their works of God. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Come on, let's give the Lord a hand of praise for his word today. Hallelujah. I believe that this word has touched someone's heart and soul today. Now, if you haven't received Jesus as your Lord of your life, then say this prayer with me. Father in heaven, I believe Jesus died and rose that I may be forgiven of my sins. I repent of my sin and I receive him as my Savior. And if any of you have drifted away and want to get back in close fellowship with God, just say, Lord, forgive me. That's all you have to say is say, God, forgive me. And please fill my heart again. Amen. Amen. So if anybody... Any new converts here today? Amen. Can you come forward? Hallelujah. And if anybody would like to join the church today, raise your hand. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. What is your name? You just accept the Lord as your Savior?
You want somebody to pray for you? Turn around and face us. Turn around. Step back and look. There you go.
Okay.
Father God, in the name of Jesus, Lord, we ask you to move on this young man, Lord. We ask you to touch his body and heal him from everything that will have called a hindrance in his life. Lord, move sadness from his life, Lord. Move all anger in the name of Jesus. Loneliness, Lord, we ask you to touch him now and give him peace in his spirit. All over this body, God, anoint this young man in the name of Jesus. Take a deep breath. The Lord is all over you right now. Receive the anointing of God. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Anoint him all over this body, God. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Are you in school? You're in college or high school? Hallelujah. God is getting ready to bless your family financially, that you're going to be able to go to school. Are you hearing me? You're going to be able to go to college. God said, don't worry about anything, because those doors will be open for you. Are you listening to God? And you must give God the glory and praise every day. You get up and begin to tell God how much you love him and how much you need him, and he'll give you the things that you need. You have to be faithful unto God. Are you listening to me? Thank you, Lord, for blessing this young man in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you. Amen.
Come on, let's give the Lord a hand of praise. Hallelujah. Turn and tell your neighbor, let's build one another. Hallelujah. What a word, what a word. Thank God for that excellent word from Dr. Brenda. We are so grateful for her. If you're here now and it is in your heart, the blessing, we provided a basket here for all those who want to give her a blessing. And I know that some put on there what says pastor's offering. They put on there her offering. If this offering's for Dr. Brenda, just scratch pastor's love and put Dr. Brenda. Amen. And be a blessing to her today for her love for the people. We are so grateful for her. Isn't it wonderful to hear our assistant pastor? Amen. Thank God. Thank God. Thank God. Wonderful word from the Lord. We are excellent, excellent. We are absolutely blessed by this word, and we are so grateful. We're looking for y'all. Want to hear talk and preach the word some more? Amen. Well, we'll look for that opportunity and give a time. We want to see how people begin to move as we're building the church. We're so grateful. Want to also say to before I begin to dismiss everyone that we are moving forward. Amen. And so we're organizing the infrastructure of the church. There are particular things they want to put together. I want to also share that I am with Elder Green going to put together a move called Men Talk.
Yes, sir.
Amen. Yes. And I want the young men to sit down and share what's in their heart with the older men. Yes. And I want the older men to pour into the younger men. And I'm going to be, along with Elder Green, the mediator of that. I also sat yesterday with a couple of hours with a gentleman, Dr. Brown, who he and I, we hit it off very well. We're going to be talking about some technological things that pertain to the further development of ministry as it goes on down the line. We know that KTYM, which is our radio broadcast station for Word on the Move broadcast, is selling their station. The owner died, and there was another person that was pertinent to that particular work who also passed away. And so they've opted to sell that business. And so we'll look for that to be a cutoff date somewhere around August for our broadcast. And all broadcasts that are on KTYM to be cut off at that time. In the meantime, we're seeking, and most everyone is seeking, another direction to go. And we sought out, I did talk with a gentleman up in Sacramento, Oregon, who's, let me see, was it? No, that was in Seattle, Washington. He is also going to be discussing some things about he can do radio and television. Told me that he can help us build our own radio station. Amen. our own television station. Now, hold on. That's going to be quite costly, and we know that to be a fact, and we, you know, you gotta arrive there financially. You gotta get to that point. But we have him in our pocket, and we have him in the background. We hold him on the shelf for a moment because we've got to be able to financially afford doing that. We also, he did also share with us that we can also do an internet broadcast. We can start our own radio station, and he can teach us how to do that. So we may well take that route. But I did also have a wonderful conversation with Dr. Brown, and he's moved to come in. So he's going to be talking with me. We're going to set up a meeting probably this Wednesday. I just will share with you that I'm going to get with Sergio and all the others that are pertaining to the technological, Judith and some of the others that are pertaining to, I think, Elder Green, Samuel, all persons that are involved with tech, even Victor, some persons who may be able to have an expertise. But somebody else here who has some expertise with technology, please let me know before you leave here. Amen? But we're going to, if you're a member of this church, of course, we want to be able to, and even if you're not a member and you're planning to join, we're going to be able to utilize, because we're looking on down the line to promote our ministry. And as it relates to that, I've spoken with Joel Jackson, who is having some products placed in Walgreens, his own line of products placed in Walgreens and in Macy's. And so he and I also have an appointment together this week, and we're going to talk about, he wants to market our ministry. He's very impressed. He said he got complete deliverance through this ministry. Now that's something to say. Complete deliverance. Not just deliverance, complete deliverance. And there, he's also at UCLA. He's a student at UCLA and about to graduate. His wife is also an instructor at UCLA. And both of them got baptized with the Holy Ghost with the evidence of speaking tongues on my sofa in my living room as I prayed for them. Amen? And so we're looking forward to that meeting so he can market, and he wants to put us on a billboard out there. And he wants to do some other methods of marketing our ministry so that we can be well known. And how many know people will come when they know you? Amen. Yes, amen. Do pray for me to finish my book called All About Marriage. God has also given me a mandate to move forward with teaching on All About Demons. So it's absolutely critical for people to know how demons operate so we can defeat them, stop them with their gains against our lives. And so I'm going to expose the devil and his games, and so everybody can get educated, and I believe that's going to be a bestseller. Amen. Praise God. And there are other books we're going to be writing now. We got to get moving, because we're looking forward to prompting our ministry out forth, and we're looking forward to building these new buildings that we're going to build. We're looking to branch out. We got to organize. We're getting it together. We're moving forward, and I want you to be in prayer for us. Amen? You got to be in prayer for your home church, and some of you, as you're growing in the development of this ministry, are going to be utilized in the working of our ministry. So you see, there's other great ministers out there. We are a great ministry that God is raising up, amen, for a specific season. And our season is fast approaching. So we've got to get it together. Amen? And so I urge you to, if you're a new member and you haven't been going to new members class, make sure you go and see Elder Keith Long here, who's heading the new members class, and get yourself indoctrinated and know the doctrine of this church. You should know our doctrine. You should be baptized in the Holy Ghost with the evidence of speaking in tongues, and you should have the inward evidence of holy living, according to Galatians 5 and 22. We want to make sure you're there, and we want to make sure that you're prospering in the Lord in the right way. And your family should be, if you're doing the proper regimen of development as the Bible teaches, you're going to prosper. Amen. Out with the old, in with the new. It's not just going to church. Hello, somebody. It's all about going to God. Because a lot of people been going to church for years and nothing has changed. But when you have developed a relationship with God and you've now committed yourself and submitted yourself into the vision of the church, whatever anointing is on that leadership will also come upon you. Amen? The apple don't fall far from the tree. You got to get in where you fit in. Praise God. And so we need to be connected. Hallelujah. You got to get in and become connected so that anointing that is on me will also come upon you. Remember that Jesus said in John 14 and 12, he said, the work that I do shall you do also and greater works. So we've got technology now so we can do greater works even through the computers. And we know we have a website where you can go on and see all up in the archives our previous sermons and teachings. And I'm doing a teaching right now called Defense Against Demons. You need to tune in because this is deep. Amen. But I made it so simple a baby can understand it. Tune in so you can get equipped and know how to fight and know the games that Satan's been playing against your body, against your family, and against your future. You got to know how to win in life. Can you say amen? And I'm telling you, you're up against some opposition. If you don't know what you're dealing with, the Bible says in Hosea 4 and 6, God says, my people are being destroyed because of a lack of knowledge. You got to understand. The Bible says, with all thy getting, get understanding. And book knowledge is good, but you need some biblical education to understand what we're fighting against. And a lot of people don't know God at all. They just know what they're hearing about God. You need to know God for yourself. Can you say amen? We need the word of God down in our heart. Hebrews 4 and 12 said the word of God is quick, powerful, sharper than a two-edged sword. It will pierce even unto the dividing asunder of soul and spirit, of the joints and marrow. It will discern thought and intent of the heart. You need to know that word. You need the word like a hawk needs slop. Let the church say amen. And so you got to get it, because without it, your family will be walking in ignorance. The Bible calls that darkness, lack of understanding. And what you don't know can and will hurt you. You cannot do what you don't know. Amen. So we need to be in the know. Tell your neighbor, get in where you fit in. Amen. No more just guessing and hearing what somebody said. Well, I heard. No, you got to know this for yourself. You need education in the ways of God. Praise God. And if you're going to, listen, there's some folks who come to church and all they do in church is play with the babies. All they do is talk. You need to be a listener in the house of the Lord. I'm not throwing darts at anybody right now. I'm just telling the truth. We need to be learning. When you go in school, there's some folks I was sitting in class with in school, all they do is just yaddy, yaddy, yaddy. You got to learn in order to develop. Don't go there. You can talk outside. Go there to learn. Learn, because that's how you're going to grow. Is that all right, church? I'm just trying to help somebody today. It's important that we get our... You got to say to yourself, I'm not just going to live and die with nothing accomplished in my life. And it's sad to be in a family where the best we got is an apartment and an old clunker car. And we just been eating bread and chicken forever. And nothing better. And nothing better. And then sickness sets in and here we go. And then we don't have money to bury couldn't it with. You understand? We need to have something. Remember, the Bible says in Proverbs 13, 22, that a good man leaves an inheritance for his children's children. Do you know what that means? That means not just his children, but he got enough left over to take care of even the grandchildren. Can the church say amen? That means he had an abundance. And God don't want you running around here leaking like a number three wash tub. God wants you to have an abundance. He said, I came to give you and to give it to you more abundantly. You are supposed to have. You're not supposed to all the time be worried about where your next meal is going to come from. Worried about if you're going to be able to pay the bills. Matter of fact, you should be out of bills now. Hello, somebody. Because the ones that you're paying bills to, they are getting rich on your money. Come on now. God wants you to be a good steward of whatever he gives you. He says be faithful over a few things, and then, somebody say, and then. And then I'll make you a ruler over many things. Some folks are missing those many things because they don't take care of the few things that God gives them. Are you listening to me? God got something waiting on you. 1 Corinthians 2:9 says, I have not seen, ear has not heard, neither hath it entered the heart of man the things that God has prepared for those who love him. He said, if you love me, in John 14:15, keep my commandments. If you don't know, you can't grow. And God's not promoting another way. He's promoting his way. He said, my ways are not your ways. My thoughts are not your thoughts. Isaiah 55:8. As the heavens are higher than the earth, so are my thoughts, my ways and my thoughts higher than yours. So God is always telling us, coming up a little bit higher. Anybody want to go higher? I heard a few amens right there. Some folks just sitting there and won't say amen. Amen means so be it. I want that. Do you know death and life is in the power of your tongue? You have not? So if you don't say nothing when I'm telling you, do you want to go high? God listen to you. Just sit there. You got to speak up for yourself. You can't just think you got it all together. No, you got to tell God, I want more. Hallelujah. I want my children to have more. Amen. I want a better heart, a better life, better health. I want a better home. I want a better car. I want better family. Can you say amen? And you don't get that by not saying anything. You get that by asking God. And you got to speak it until your system believes it. Because faith cometh by and hearing by. So say what God says concerning you. Say it all the time till it gets down in you and motivates you to want to do better. And you start hanging around broke folk, pitiful folk, crying folk all the time, you're going to act just like they act. Touch somebody, say, get in where you fit in. Amen. Now that I've got all that off my chest, I'm going to take my little wife out, celebrate her today, and we're going to ride off into the sunset. Praise the Lord. Now, let me also congratulate our loving and wonderful woman of God, Dolores Ingram. Amen. Would you, because I understand, isn't this somewhere around the proximity of your birthday? Huh? I remember. Whoa, praise the Lord. Would you raise your hand right there? Look at, look at, look, that's one of our sisters in the Lord. Come on, give her a hand of praise. Say happy birthday, Sister Dolores. All right. Are any other birthday folk in here today? Where? Dr. Kamel Howard, give him a happy birthday here today. Bless God. Don't he light that sax up? Bring life and beauty into the congregation. Doris Carter says, who else? Who else? Ethel Singleton. Stick your head in the door there, Ethel. She's a lady behind the door looking classy. Come on in here. Ethel just turned 21. Praise the Lord. Can we say this before we get out of here? We're out here. We're done before 1 o'clock, but I don't want to hold us any longer. We got somebody else? Who? Carol Hall. Where's Sister Carol? There she is. Happy birthday. Listen, let's all collectively sing it. Come on, Sergio, hit it.
Happy birthday to you. Come on, I can hear you. Happy birthday.
Come on.
Happy birthday, everybody. Hey. Happy birthday to you.
Come on, give him a hand of praise. Bless God for every one of you. We are so absolutely grateful for you and for God adding another day to you. We're happy. Listen to me. If you be happy, God will send happiness to you.